always known that I've been interested in making things, and finally in high school I decided that I had wanted to make art.
I used to have drawing contests with my mom. It was the only thing I was really interested in, so I had to come here.
Like, all the girls in high school would come to me with their jeans and then sew it to a skirt.
I've really always been a writer, even since I was like a little kid. That's just been what I do.
Boy, I always loved art since I was like a little, especially clothes. I just like designing clothes.
Because it's been in my life, for all of my life. It kind of just snowballed into what it is now, and I'm here at Pratt and, you know, learning how to do what I want to do.
This is a picture I took last summer when I was home on Venice Beach. I was working there. This guy has been there for 20, 30 years. Apparently, this is his old wrestling picture. He used to be a wrestler. I've taken photos of him a couple times, and he took out these two photographs. What I really love about it is that he's looking at them, not at me. I think that's what's wonderful about it.
Everyone starts off doing the sort of foundation year with the light studies, figure studies, color theory.
I love drawing. I love 3D design. The best part about it is you just learn so much in such a short time. You learn pattern making, you learn construction, you learn sketching, you learn textiles. You learn everything from day one through the 4 years you're here.
If you don't know how to draw, you'll sure as hell learn how to draw.
There's a lot of hard work involved, and there's a lot of thought involved in it. It's not all rainbows and absinthe. Even if you have talent, that's great. You still have to do the work.
I would have these 8-hour homework sessions. I would wake up with like art material in my hair. Secretly, I was smiling because I wanted to do this.
Telling my friends about that at home, that all have, you know, studying for their finals, and I'm like, oh, my final is a nude full-size self-portrait, and they were like, what?
Every class we learn something new. Every class we build on what we learned from the last class, and then you look back and you're like, wow, like, I actually know how to do everything.
So this poem is called Dirty River. He says he's all long, hot, summered out. Thinks he'll catch a train south to New Jersey, land of dirty rivers. Maybe north to New Hampshire, land of wood smoke and pine. He's never been, but thinks he can sluice down a mountainside like sweat beating off the back of a girl with blue lips.
You know, we're one of the only schools in the entire city that has a true campus.
It's just fantastic. I mean, there's people hanging out on the lawn. There's all different majors, people walking around with, you know, screens and canvases, computers, everything. Like, it's just a fantastic mix of everything. And that's one of the things that really attracted me to Pratt.
I've always been interested in painting interiors that are very personal.
Very grand, big ideas.
My apartment, in my room.
I don't like working small. I like working really big scale.
Dealing with texts and pattern.
I've started really appreciating Walt Whitman.
The relationship between objects and humans.
Embracing your own personal power.
The spaces that humans occupy.
There's one line that's very easy to remember.
Indicators of their personality.
Urge and urge and urge, always the procreant urge of the world.
Yeah.
Multiple directions exaggerated here, this piece projecting out, this projecting out into space, that's working really nicely.
I think I'm also gonna bring the lips up a bit because it seems like they sort of butt up with the nose a little bit more.
I don't think so.
No?
I don't think so. I think it's the definition of the top of the lip.
Okay.
That what we're seeing is the split.
Oh, okay.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah,
if the top of the lip is there, you're right there.
Okay, cool.
That proportion's already there. You may want to delineate that just a bit.
Yeah,
but feel it.
I've applied to the most prestigious schools in New York, you know, FIT, Pratt, Parsons. Ultimately, I chose Pratt because the teachers are true professionals, and it just seems like you really get the most from this school.
Nice sense of volume inside the cat space.
Grind that off, then the weld is engaged.
The professors, they're all really wonderful. They're all practicing and certified designers and architects, really well connected in this area. That's usually how you kind of get your foot in the door in this industry, is when you know people.
You've got to always consider this. Someone's going to wear it, right?
The fact that they take us seriously, and not as just a student, but as someone who is taken seriously as an artist, that's very important.
Everything's here. The capital of the world. You know, some of the most famous galleries in the world are half an hour away by train, and it's fantastic. And literally every day, there's something to do.
I mean, it's New York. You can't get this kind of experience in any other city. Like, I started off school in Chicago, and it was like the goal for everyone there was to graduate and then come to New York.
I read something really interesting yesterday that was about New York, and they said that everybody that comes here wants to be either the best or really, really good at something. Is that why I came here? I realized that, yeah, it is kind of, I really want to be the best or like really, really good.
I really enjoyed comics, but I saw animation, I'm like, wow, this is really interesting. Working in the fourth dimension really intrigued me. You're basically creating life on screen because it moves, making things come to life. And I think that's really beautiful. Book Girl and Cabinet Girl go through this journey together, and they find that in the end, their friendship is what's most important.
I think what surprises me most is how constructive the studio environment is and how much I actually get from the people I'm working with.
Being surrounded by artists is something that you need to have. You know, it's really great to be here working on a project and having your friends sitting next to you and saying like, hey, you should try this, or, you know, maybe you should use this color, or I don't really understand that, do you get it? And that's really what it's about.
I like packaging assignments, I think, the best. There's something about doing something that's not flat that's really exciting. One of the assignments was about green packaging. It's the first time I've had to consider, like, you know, how much cutting is involved, how much wasted material is involved in packaging. We focused on green that way. I mean, you want to create something that's interesting to the consumer. You want them to get something out of it.
Maybe I'll work for a magazine. I want to travel the world. I want to go to as many places that I can and meet as many people as I can. Take pictures of all of it. I mean, that's what I want to do.
I want to do couture evening wear. That's what I want to do. I think it's more interesting to look at couture garment. It's all hand sewing, mostly, and it takes a lot of work to do. So usually only one of a kind is produced.
I've talked to some girls that have already graduated, and some of them are working for companies that design for like Forever 21. In H&M, or they're working on their own lines.
There's this one firm I have my eyes on. I think if I'm lucky enough to start off as a junior designer with one of the top firms, later on have my own design practice, I think that would be my dream job.
I came from a really kind of technical background, a lot of math, a lot of science. Pratt pushed me in a direction that I wouldn't have gone otherwise. For the past like almost year, my area of focus has been building this bicycle. And it's all very, very thin, so the actual final weight of the bike is very light. It's lighter than pretty much all other commuter bikes on the market right now. The reason this is a safer bicycle is because your seat is high enough that you can see other cars around you. This is hopefully going to be going into production soon. I mean, I know a lot of people in the bike industry who are very interested.
What does it take to be great? I think it just takes determination, and you need to, I know it sounds cheesy, but you need to believe in yourself.
There are nights where you don't sleep at all. There are days, actually, when you don't sleep at all. But in the end, like, you have produced something. It's concrete. You can show it to the world and say, like, ah, look what I did. It's fantastic. It's magical.
When you get out of school, there's nobody telling you to make paintings, and you have to get to the point where it's not about doing assignments.
You have to want to be great. It's a hard process, and if you don't put your time in, you're not going to get it back.
Art is what moves you. Art is what makes us human. Creation is what makes you human.
Art definitely matters. It's not a frivolous endeavor. I think it's how we know ourselves as a culture.
It defines us as human beings. Only the humans create these kind of things, and it's miraculous.
All through history, the artist's job has been to inspire people and get them to think in different ways.
We can create anything if we really think about it and if we really try.